Okay, we'll go ahead and call the Board of Works and Safety meeting to order. It is 3:30 p.m. on Tuesday, July 19th, 2022. Roll call, please.
Daniel.
Here.
Penrod.
Here.
Crowder.
Here.
In front of you are the minutes from our last meeting on June 28th. Were there any changes or corrections? Okay.
Make a motion to accept the meeting news, or the minutes from Tuesday, June 28th, Board of Works meeting as presented.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion? All those in favor show by the usual sign. It is unanimous. Next up is the encroachment agreement, and that is for 766 North Norfolk Cove. Come on up, Carson. I need name and address, please, even though I just said it. Okay. And what is it that you're wanting to do? Okay. Okay. Yeah, I was going to say, typically when we agree on these, we just let the resident know that if we need to get in there in an emergency, we will take it down, and then it's your responsibility to put it back up. Obviously, we'll be gentle with it. But if we know in advance, we'll let you know, and you can do it, you know, or whatever. But I'm sure it does. I'm sure it does. Utilities, any issues with this property? No. Okay. Well, I know that, but that doesn't... Okay. Any concerns from the board?
No.
Okay. I'll make a motion that we approve the encroachment agreement for 766 North Norfolk Cove as presented.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion? All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It is unanimous. Thank you, sir. So now, next process.
It will get back to the planning commission. I'll get it sent over tomorrow, and then we just get back to them.
Next process.
Thank you.
Nope. You're free to go. Okay. Thanks. Okay. So we'll go ahead and move number 8 up here, which is the ordinance violation extension request. No? Oh, with Van Buren. Okay, I thought you meant the ordinance. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, so never mind. We will not move that up. So we'll do the sidewalk and parking spaces blocked off in front of 217 West Van Buren, the street closure request, if you will. Come on up.
And I'll apologize a little bit because I kind of filled this out for him based on what he's told me. So
oh, okay.
You can ask the question.
Okay. Hello there.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Good. Name and address, please.
My name is Mark Sunday. Mm-hmm. Do you want to get a best for the business?
Okay.
Draw the best.
There you go. Okay. That's fine. 217 West Van Buren. Okay, very good. So I'm trying to decipher what Rosie wrote down here.
I can tell you.
Okay, that'd be great. Okay.
Kathy asked me to come in and take a look at her facade, the fascia, because her home got ripped off of that store.
Sure.
And I told her it was the only way that I'm safely going to do this. Section where I put scaffolding up, because it starts at like 10 to 12 foot. The first break is at 20.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to, and there's more damage clear to the top of 40. So,
that's
what we need to do. Can't even hardly assess the damage. We can get that on the long haul. So,
okay.
Craig picked me over here to you. I went to Craig first. He said he didn't need any permits or anything. But,
yeah.
I just want to make sure that comply with the city, make sure everything's safe.
Sure.
Now, I'm more worried about everybody else.
Sure. Do we think it's only going to be 3 parking spaces in front, 4 parking
my
spaces?
My trailer is 27 feet.
Okay.
I can unhook it from the truck. So, you know, my work trailer is 27 foot.
Yeah.
Each spot is about 9 feet. You know, if we go in the side door, then we should be able to do maybe just 3.
Mm-hmm.
If we drop the ramp, that's another 10
yeah.
foot. You know, that'd be
so you'd be mm-hmm. trailer parked there until you were done. Is that what you
no.
No, you'd take it home every night and bring it back?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, we could leave it there, but I mean, if people need to park it, leave it. I'm not going to be there working. So there's no need to, you know, have to be stuck there every night. I imagine this is going to take a whole week to set up a scaffolding up, assess what's going to have to be repaired, and get all repaired.
And if I understand what you had told me, that you're trying to work this in so you really don't have a date.
Yeah, no.
Okay. That's mainly why I don't have dates on here.
Yeah, I gotcha.
He just doesn't know.
Just like most contractors. We're already booked
out. I'm sure.
Things arise when you say you're
yeah, I hear you. So there's 3 spots basically directly in front of Bravo that, I mean, really, you probably could say 4 in front of Bravo, sort of, that I think you probably would have enough room going into the alleyway a little bit there. If your ramps, if you will, or whatever, are going into the alley just for temporary.
No, the ramp would go the other way.
The ramp would go the other way.
So I said, we leave the ramp up, we do it on the outside.
Okay.
We would pull up,
yeah.
Truck would be sitting in the alleyway, and look at
yeah.
The trucks on the west.
How many, I'm sorry, you may have answered this and now I've forgotten. Do you have an idea of how many days it's going to take?
A whole week,
okay. So do you think 4 spaces would be enough then?
Okay.
Any thoughts, questions, comments, concerns?
Is this going to be closed to pedestrians, or are you building a temporary walk around?
That's why I came here to see, you know, we're going to set the scaffolding up. You know, I'm going to block off where the scaffolding is so they can't try to walk underneath it, whatever. We don't need to be, that sidewalk is plenty wide. We don't need to block the sidewalk completely off. They can walk out and still travel back.
Yeah, so it could be, so I guess my, yeah, trying to figure out a workaround there. Again, I don't know that there's that many pedestrians that are going back and forth, but there are some that you may have to just accommodate somehow to get around in some way, shape, or form. So. Sure.
Yeah, that's why the scaffolding is, I think it's 5 foot wider. Sidewalk is probably 10 foot wide.
Yeah.
So there's still plenty.
So you still have plenty of room there. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm good. The only other thing I would say is just notifying the neighboring businesses when you get ready for work. Anything else from the board? Do you have any questions as well?
Yeah, I was just making sure we didn't close it off for those who want to be.
Yeah, so they don't
sure.
have to go over the alley.
Yeah. Okay.
So is the alley going to be left, the north-south alley here, is it going to be left unobstructed?
Yeah. We'll unload the truck and move the truck.
Gary.
You said something about moving the trailer every night.
We can.
Is it a problem moving it?
No, it's not a problem either.
That'd be a parking, you know, because we're going
to it. It'd be more worthwhile just to leave it there, honestly.
Once we get it open up to get in there.
Okay. And how much of advance notice can you let us know?
2 weeks.
2 weeks? Oh, okay. That's okay. Is that what you're going to ask?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll make a motion. We approve the tree closing permit request for the 4 spaces in front of Bravo Baskets from the alleyway over for M&D.
Yeah.
M&D. With 2 caveats. Number 1, that let the adjacent businesses know, and number 2, that you give us 2 weeks' notice.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion? All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It's unanimous. Okay.
So we'll do that email.
I'll let you know.
And then I will notify the departments. Okay.
Great. Thank you.
Thanks.
Next up is a permit to cut into curved streets or alleys for 315 North Sweetbriar Court. Any concerns from the department heads on this? Looks like it's a NIPSCO line. I make a motion we approve the permit to cut into curved streets or alleys for 315 North Sweetbriar Court as presented.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion? All those in favor show the usual sign. It's unanimous. Next up is the permit to cut into curved streets or alleys for South Dreams, James Street, and West Business 30. Is this part of Westgate Project?
No.
No? Okay. It says Lumen proposed to move the facilities out of conflict to the back of the right-of-way so new drainage can be placed. But that's not our drainage.
I have to assume it is, but I had no clue. So.
Okay. It's at the corner of the...
Yeah.
Lost it. Okay.
It's already been our
drainage. Okay. Well, to me, it looks like they're just trying to reroute Lumen lines, right? So, anybody have any issues with that? Okay, I'll make a motion. We approve the permit to get them curved streets or alleys for South James Street, West Business 30 for Lumen.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion? All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It's unanimous.
Mayor?
Yes. Okay. Well, they have approval to do the project. If they want to change it, then I guess they have to deal with you, right? The pole attachments?
I already approved the pole attachments.
Oh, okay. Okay. Mike, Skata.
$24,988.97 is the first step before we can move any farther. The other water towers have already been converted over because of the new stations that we put in. Ellsworth, 300, 700, and 350. Those stations have already been converted over to the new radio system and talked to those towers. We have to have this one done next, so this will be our first step to have this done, and this converts it over to the new radio system. So we can start the upgrade. And then the second part of this is from Donahue themselves, as far as putting in the equipment that is needed for the new radios to talk on the current system, which we don't currently have in there, but since the radios are different, they operate on a different system. So we have to have some different controllers and different things put in. All said in total, it's just under $450,000, but I've split that up over the next 4 years to do. So this first part, by converting over 11 stations, also gives us, that leaves us about 9 to be converted, but that gives us 11 spare radios over the course of doing this. Implemented over several years, we'll have spare radios that we can use if something goes wrong with one. We'll have one for every station and then 2 extra. So by doing this the first year, it's the cheapest. Next year, I think it's probably the most expensive year. I don't have my paper right in front of me. But the new one for Donahue is $53,510. And I forget, I think the total of that, like I said, I forgot my paper, is $78,000. But that's what I'm requesting, to approve these two quotes, the one from Donahue and the one
24 stations by doing 11 of them here, that's almost half the first year. But some of the other ones are going to take extensive work, so they're going to be a lot more expensive too, than the bird cover. So I went the cheapest route first because we had a lot of projects to run on that year.
Questions of Mike?
Did Donnie just have any kind of a agreement or anything?
Yes, we have a speed agreement. We've already signed that, and that's not what this is. This is the actual work, but we have an agreement with him.
For the 53?
No, not for the 53.
I think what Rosie's asking is that to approve the 53, we have an agreement to sign that approves the 53. We have, because we have a document that has an attachment that includes the whole $417,000, but I don't know that we have a document, at least that I don't have a document, that shows us the place to sign.
Because they sent the whole thing as one, and I split it up myself. They did not split it. I split it.
Okay.
Unless the city wants to dive in for the $400,000, which I don't think is a good idea.
I'm sorry, what'd you ask?
Okay.
I kind of split that up myself, but I can have them grab something and send that back to you.
Okay.
Yeah. If we get it approved, then I can have it around that.
Okay.
If you're right with having the mayor really sign that.
Yeah. I'll make a motion. We approve the J&K Communications, Inc. request, the quote. Just lost it. For, I'll get there, $24,988.97.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion? All those in favor show by the usual sign. It's unanimous. I'll make a motion. We approve the telemetry upgrade information or telemetry upgrade for or from it's from Donahue, right?
Correct.
From Donahue, with only the amount of $53,510.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion?
And that is all equipment that Donahue will purchase, install, program,
right,
and everything for.
All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It is unanimous. Okay. Thanks, Mike.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Next up is an ordinance violation extension request for 401 Wallace Avenue. Rosie?
Okay. These are it's a lot of weeds around the house, and they requested that they have somebody to help get it done, taken care of, but they needed a couple weeks extension. That was the first end of last week. They were supposed to get a letter, but they haven't. I'm doing it for the pictures. All but the last one.
Did they have a specific request as to how many weeks?
I think they had a salary for 2 weeks.
2 weeks from last
yeah,
whatever last day.
Yeah. Yeah, I think the 15th
was the next day. Was there a sign posted in the yard for tall grass, or was it just? This, since it's just high in weeds.
Flowers around it.
Yeah. And they have somebody coming in to clear that.
They said, yeah, they could get somebody to come in and do it, but it's going to be a couple of weeks.
I don't think 2 weeks.
Okay.
That's fine with me.
Okay. Someone want to make a motion?
I'll make a motion. We grant the extension of 2 weeks to the Morrises at 401 Wallace Avenue to take their leave.
So if you want to say July, say the 25th, that's on a Monday. Or no, wait. No, the July 29th is on a Friday.
I'll second. Motion second for the discussion. All in favor, show by the usual sign. It's unanimous. Okay, bills.
I'll make a motion to pay all accounts payable vouchers in the amount of $3,017,541.17 from the allowance of accounts payable vouchers dated July 19th, 2022.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion. All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It's unanimous.
I'll make a motion to pay all pay types except overtime in the amount of $271,559.53 plus overtime in the amount of $11,106.33 from the pay file ending 7/1/2022.
Second.
Motion seconded. Further discussion. All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It's unanimous.
And I'll make a motion to pay all pay types except overtime in the amount of $8,800 for third quarter clothing allowance from the pay file ending 7/8/2022.
Second. Motion second. Further discussion. All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It is unanimous. Okay. Fireman head reports. Mike.
I need to ask that we can hire another employee. I lost one. A couple weeks ago, and also I have another that's retiring, and I believe we figured 38 days.
So you what?
Permission to at least hire one and possibly look to hire two.
Okay. Questions? Thoughts?
It's just replacing people.
Right.
Okay. Yep. Okay, you got approval.
Okay.
Is that it?
That's it.
Okay. Mike.
Try and make it fast.
We received a control panel for Columbia Shores today, the new one, so that project's moving along. We'll start with the bypass first. I got a preliminary drawing and waiting on the final points for that, but I'm making sure that I can, once I approve the drawing, then I'll be able to move forward. July storm event that we had that dumped so much rain and rain we had this weekend. All of our systems handled everything great. I was out of town for the storm, I believe it was on the 3rd or the 4th. One or two, I can't remember what day it was. Everything, the EQ base and everything, they turned the equipment on, everything was the way it was supposed to, the testing, everything. We didn't have any violations this time, so I'm really proud of the guys on how they worked with each other and individuals that were on call during that handled everything, and they just do a good job. They're in a group range, basically. Surveys have been completed for the horse main project, Harrison Main Street. Tony, you have that information, and it'd be great working on that. And I met with Midwestern engineers on the CSO project at the treatment plant to have that redone. And they've also done their survey work the day before and met and took some measurements and photos. So we should have some type of a preliminary drawing or sketches during the next couple of weeks. So that's all I have on that question.
Question to Mike. Thank you. Gary.
We had 5 officers put in for the sergeant's position. We had 2 interviews yesterday, and we're going to have 3 tomorrow. So I look forward to that, getting that position filled. Detectives have submitted a resignation letter. It will be effective on December 30th. We will go back to the group control. Did the Board of Works interviews with the 3 candidates today. I'm excited about that. See where that goes. Dispatch did the spilling patch this morning at 10 a.m.
So, word on that note, as you know, we had interviews today for, we've already approved one opening in the past that he was hiring for. There's a potential for multiple other changes happening in the department that will leave us shorthanded. So after talking to Gary, I think we'd like to move forward with potentially hiring all three of those members, those that interviewed today, pending the financial approval of our clerk treasurer. I guess what I would ask is the Board of Works approval of hiring all three contingent on Rosie's financial approval. You good? Okay. So we'll go ahead. You got approvals. Okay. Sean.
Well, we're continuing our work out at Westgate in the last phase of our underground. We're going to convert it underground. So that's going well. And also just one other thing to be aware of. August 9th will be the opening, bid opening for Main Street. Those bids should have went out last week. So hopefully we start giving those in. And on August 9th, we'll open bids and we'll take them into consideration for the following meeting. So.
Questions? Okay. Thank you. Tom?
Training on our newest firefighter is going very well. She's got two more checkoffs to do and she'll be out on her own then, able to cover a shift. Our interviews for, I just sent a thing to Beth. I think our interviews are going to be next Friday, not this coming Friday, but the Friday after the 29th, to fill the other position that was opened up with a retirement and or late moved on. So that happens next Friday, and then we'll be coming for you with hopefully a candidate or two candidates to move into. So.
Questions, Tom? Thank you. Mark?
I haven't been here since the fireworks, so fireworks went well, and I want to thank the electricians, police and fire for their help. Really, it was a good night, so we're real happy with how things went there. Aquatic Center, staying busy on these warmer days. When it gets moving out, it's not so busy, but today was busy. Have a swim meet tonight, and we did have some Lutheran staff come over today, which kind of neat to have them there. They took some video footage, interviewed a lifeguard, and they're doing a session on pool safety with one of their doctors. And so they chose our pool to come over and get video footage. I thought it was pretty neat. Doing a lot of mowing. We started cutting back the riverbank today along the trail. It does look a lot different. It just kept growing closer to the trail, so the guys did a lot of work on that today. JFL registration ends this week, and we'll be starting football practices and giving out equipment next week. Had a lot of baseball tournaments. We had one last weekend. Have one softball tournament next weekend. That's really kind of about it.
What's the mark? Thank you. Chip?
Westgate, the drainage is, I would say, about 98% complete, and hopefully by the end of the week, they'll start cutting the roads.
Yep, and on that note, I have that in front of me. Sally sent out a message today that the first pay application is in for a. I just want to make sure I'm understanding. Is that for the 205-535? Okay. Okay. So the pay application's on there. I'll make a motion. We approve the pay application for the Westgate Subdivision Project in the amount of $205,535.75. Motion seconded. Further discussion? All those in favor show by the usual sign. It is unanimous. Anything else, Chip?
No.
Thank you. Rosie?
I don't have anything.
I don't think I have anything. Paul? No. Nicole?
No.
We have no audience? We have no press? Marcia?
Nothing.
Okay, then we'll call the meeting adjourned. Thank you.
Okay. Just in time.
Marcia.
Oh. No, very fun.